Oh, Lord Jesus. Yeah, I get somebody with that one. Lord, amen. I have met more African Americans in my life who are guru than I need to meet for the rest of my life. You go to Church's Chicken, you go to McDonald's, you go to Popeye's, you go to Walmart, you go to Krispy Kreme, you go to Parks, you go to the store, you go anywhere. You're going to find yourself a rude and arrogant Negro.
Amen.
And I want to ask you, did nobody tell you to come to work today? Did nobody tell you to take this job? Did nobody tell you to act like that? Why are you trying to put your bad life on my spirit? Why are you being rude to me and then I stand up for who I am? You got a problem with me defending myself. Oh, see, that ain't love. You don't need to be rude to me just because you made some bad choices. You don't need to be rude to me just because you made a mistake or seven. I will say or two, but I know I made several mistakes. Well, you don't need to be rude to me if you plan on loving me. Love is what love does. Love ain't rude. Love ain't boastful. Love ain't braggadocious. Love ain't egotistical. Love ain't self-centered. Love ain't all about itself. Love is caring and kind. Paul thinks, seems to think that these qualities of life, and a loving person can be patient and kind, or you can be egotistical, envious, braggadocious, boastful, arrogant, rude. You can choose one or the other, but you don't have to make a choice. You can be one day and one the next. Because I read in the Bible that a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. He came to night to me on a Sunday, and by the time to get into the parking lot, you don't even know my name. He came to night to me at the boom boom, and then when you see me in church, act like we don't know each other. He came to night to me on Sunday school, and then when you see me down at the casino, you can't look at me in the face, because I might be there for a whole another reason. I'm going to tell you about love this morning. Love is everything that you should not be when you're in love with sin. Sin will get you in trouble every time. And get you out of love before you know it. If you allow sin in your life, then you allow hatred in your life. If you allow sin in your life, then you allow braggadociousness in your life. I'm reminded that Paul is very clear on this. He tells a story that I want to talk to you about. This man married this woman 40 years ago. bled and he bled and he hopped. Not only did he